All right. Now, I had you muted anyway, so I probably couldn't hear, but I think it's online again now.
Are we good?
Yeah, we're all good, guys.
That was such
guys.
A good intro, too. Yeah, it was, you it was, really it was, had a good flow.
We're on point. We're on point. So I didn't really want to stop you, but I felt like, if no one's going to be able to hear it.
Well, I'm glad that you like my intro, even if it was when the stream was offline. You know, very sad
times. It was
time.
Easily the best intro ever made.
Yeah, okay, that was something that should go down in the history books.
Yeah.
Out on the stream, you guys missed out. That was the best intro I've ever done, and it was just not being broadcasted. All right, so I'm just going to check. Yeah, it seems to be running just fine, but if it stops again, you know, just let me know and we'll figure it out. I'm not sure what that was, but something made the stream stop. Okay, now we're back. So let me do this anyway. I'll try again. It won't be as good, but, you know, I got to try. We're watching the SLTV Star Series Season 10. You're at Room on Fire, and it's Fnatic versus Tyson. Best of one game. Remember, more than anything, to tune back in tomorrow, where we have our own King of the Hill tournament with three best of three games sponsored by Case King, Alban Fruin, and also Beat Phoenix. Really appreciate you guys hanging out with us, and hope you guys will tune in tomorrow again. But let's go. What do you guys think? The Swedes versus the French? How is this going to unfold?
I'm going to put my money on Fnatic.
Yeah, I will too. And the reason being... let's see. Right, because Ven and I were just talking about this. But I think Titan is kind of like a little bit of an LDLC thing, where I think they're just now getting back into the house and practicing again regularly. So I'm wondering if, you know, they're still trying to shake off the rust a little bit, like LDLC have over the past few days. You know, Hellraisers, as we all know, have been boot camping for several days now in preparation for Valencia, which is coming up this weekend. So, you know, they've been putting in the work, but, you know, have Titan had time to get warmed up again and back into the rhythm. That's something that we have to wonder here, because Fnatic, we've seen quite a few games out of them, you know, over the last few days. So we know that they have been definitely putting in work.
That they have, I mean, there's no doubt about that. They've been practicing a lot, but it is always different practice and playing in an actual official match. So maybe the game against Hellraisers, it was the one to sort of put them back in the right frame of mind. And I don't know. I think this is going to be an incredibly close game. And I'm actually going to call it 16-14 in favor of Titan. I think they might win.
Even putting out the result there.
Yeah, oh, damn.
I like that. Yeah, you're going 16, all in. 16,
gotta try 14. It. Yeah, I think it's going to be a very close one. I hope it's going to be a close one too, but we're live, and it is Titan who gets to start on the CT side, so if they can just win a pistol round, then they will be off to a fine start.
All right, I'm going to quote Double Walk, say 16-10, Fnatic.
All right, yeah. Well, you take, you know, sources that are maybe a little bit biased here.
If it ends up 16-10, we know what's happened.
Oh, yeah, then Devil Walk, definitely.
Match fixing all over the place.
Yeah, because he guessed that. Oh, what are they doing? Titan, they're moving so aggressively, and Fnatic are right here in apartments to hear it all. They are going to charge down, and actually, if Flusher gets caught with the bomb here, that would be a disaster. But right now, I'm not so sure this is great for Titan. They are very split up. That grenade not going to kill Pronax, but that's a little bit of damage. They have got the opening frag. This is a confusing round.
I mean, that's the thing, but the thing is that Titan have still managed to survive this for the most part and get back to the sites. Now they've got two guys waiting on B, a great nade there to catch Pronax, so now they've got a two-man advantage, and they've set up their defense once again.
Oh god, I mean, oh, a great shot from Scream. He wants one more headshot. He's actually going to throw away his pistol. Doesn't want to go down with it in his hand. He was out of bullets, obviously, and now they're going to try and rush in here, but it's a 2-on-4. They go back towards the B bomb site, which is the best move they've made yet here, Fnatic. They might still be able to do it if they can drop NBK, but he's going to peek out at just the right time and does great damage to both players, but doesn't get the kill, so this is going to be a bomb plant either way. I mean, Fnatic aren't out of this round yet.
They are not. I mean, they've somehow managed to sneak a bomb plant in here. 17 seconds and they get the plant. Now, do Titan manage to get the retake here? Flusha and Krims, these guys absolutely capable. As we saw yesterday, Krims had a stellar game. He's gonna go for it, goes leaping out, but Smith point blank with the 5-7 picks him out of the air, and now it's all down to Krims behind new boxes. 1v3, he gets one, takes out existence. He's still here, he's getting closed in on though. They're gonna sandwich him in, and they get the kill in the end. Kenny Ash on top of the bomb with the kid as well. Will get the defuse, and Titan save it in the end.
Okay, then. So, I mean, there were so many things that happened this pistol round. We can't even really talk about it in time. But one tiny detail that I really enjoyed. So this is just really sort of, you know, microscopic stuff. But Smith's, when he came in from Banana, the way he set up, because he knew that the guy planted the bomb was going to be by Oranges. He could hear that. So all he did was try and check if there was anyone in Dark who was ever going to peek. So actually, Smith's, by just sitting and waiting, got a lot of information about where the last two players were. So that was just like a tiny detail at the end. If he had gone for it alone in the 1-on-2, it could have ended up horrible for his team. So just good audio work coming out from Smith there.
I think also what they did, the kind of rotations they made and how they pushed down Banana after MBK ran down and submitted and got the entry frag on JW, I think that was big. And that was like a perfect rotation for Titan, which is nice to see, seeing how some of their execution and the game versus Hellraisers were a bit off.
Yeah,
that was just a really smooth move because they got out of that situation with
this. MBK Mag 7. The first kill, Sin almost gets the second one. He's got a little bit of backup and existence here. And actually, yeah, the Belgian in-game leader is going to pick another kill off. The bomb will go down, so good job, Fnatic. I mean, that's two bomb plants in two rounds. That means they're going to be able to buy the next round. They did not buy body armor either, so they will have a lot of money. That's actually pretty good work from the Swedes. Although, I mean, we know that Devilwalk is watching this game because he's in the chat right now. How painful do you think it was for Devilwalk to see his whole team in the apartments and then see Titan running down middle and not being able to tell them?
That's a pretty painful moment.
We feel for you, Devilwalk. We do.
No doubt about it. But yeah,
this is Titan... coaches around the world.
Yeah. Well, Titan solved that in the pistol round really nicely, I think. I think that was one of the reasons why they were able to win the round in the end as well. Because they got out of there without taking too much damage, and they also stabilized it as well. They got two people towards the B bomb site, had the normal amount of three, you know, towards the A bomb site, and they weren't really shaken up by in any way after going so aggressive. And Fnatic were definitely out of loss of what was going on.
This is such an interesting setup with the three people over at A. Even when they have an AWP, they could have left Kenny alone in the B bomb site if they wanted to and gone for an A. But they still start off the round the first 30 seconds just having that guy there. Kenny takes the peak middle. Now he's finally here, gets one. And there are two more right up close, and Kenny is going to go down. Really swift movement from Crims. Nicely done.
Very good chase there by Crims. Not letting Kenny get out of there in one piece. That is crucial that he managed to get that kill. Put Kenny down and managed to get it back to a 4-on-4. That's what Fnatic need going into this, as there's 40 seconds left on this clock. They've got the smoke for Library and a good flash around the corner to lead the way. But the defense is still strong here on this A site. They need to root them out.
Yeah, actually Molotov going to come in and try and see if they can just block off some of the bomb side, but Olofmeister is still going to get the plant down here, and NBK only had a mag 7, so he's going to have to battle that with a pistol, so actually that weakens the defense a lot. NBK, I think he's going to have to wait for some backup here, and it will be coming right about now. Smith's walking in, NBK takes one, he goes down, Olofmeister found in the corner is going to die, but this is still working out great for Fnatic. Scream! Even as he's blind, it picks up that kill, and the bomb is not planted right now for Flusher. Oh, Scream, if you realized, you could have gone for it straight away.
He's gonna go for it. He has no fear. He's going to go for it. No! Scream comes off.
What?
How? He had 2 seconds left.
Why?
Why did he come off?
That was painful to even watch, and I can't even imagine what it must be like being in the game, because, I mean, I guess he thought... Flusher? I think it was Flusher. I think it thought Flusher was much closer than he was. That was a big misplay, of course, but... I mean,
but you have to know those kind of things. That's where you have to use the sound for what it's worth. That 9 out of 10 times, he should be 100% certain that he can get that defuse. Like, that shouldn't be an issue for a player of this caliber.
No, and... I think they should have even known that the bomb wasn't planted there, because when the bomb went down, they had MBK in apartments and existence in the pit. So Titan actually had a lot of reasons to know that the bomb was planted in that position initially. That was some very confusing communication coming out here from the French team, and it cost them the round ultimately. Now they are doing pretty well in this round, and MBK is going to pick off Olofmeister, turns around and gets down by Crims, so trading back and forth all the time at the moment. Existence made some pretty good timing, but not a good enough rifle to take down Crims, and it's going to be down to Kenny, who has to just try and save this rifle, I think.
Yeah, I agree. Kenny, it'd be suicide to go to A site right now. He just needs to set up to save. If he wants to get greedy, he sets up for an exit, but really he should just be looking to get as far away as possible, get this save in, because they don't have much money at all. NBK is the only one sitting on any kind of cabbage right now with 2K to the bank. So this is big. I don't know. I wouldn't, like, there's no saying it like that, but that last round from Scream, that's got to be rattling there for Titan. At the same time, those were two great kills from Crims. The one on NBK was a near-instant headshot on him as he came around the corner in apartments. Of course, Crims knew that he was there, seeing as how he just lost a teammate, but then the kill on Existence as well. Just two very big kills there that allowed Fnatic to get onto that A site.
Yeah, I mean, even though Fnatic won, I felt like Fnatic would win the round the entire time, but it still should have been Titan's round, because Fnatic got that A bomb site so effortlessly. Really, yeah. I mean, they picked off Kenny S instantly after he got the entry frag with Crims being up close in Arch, and then they, you know, committed properly and actually executed fast. And yeah, I'm actually surprised that they got in that much trouble, and it actually came down to a big mistake from Scream, actually, for Fnatic to win the round.
That is true enough. I mean, that was just, so far it's been two very confusing rounds. The pistol round, of course, was completely chaotic, so we're in for a bit of a game here, it seems like. This time, of course, they only have the one rifle on Kenny, and he's already down to 45. They can pick up Flusher, maybe they can get one more rifle, and that might work out great. Scream peeking out does go down immediately. Flusher, the top fragger right now, and doing a fine job.
Yeah, Flusher, he gets another one. Now, does he realize that Kenny is waiting around the corner? Because Kenny's already eaten a nade. A great HE that went on him at the beginning, and he's actually going to catch Flush off guard. Good clean kill there by Kenny, but he's in a 1-on-4. This, again, Kenny S has to just try and save. Just get away, but Fnatic, they're not going to let him. They're already on the hunt, and they're very close as well.
Yeah, this time it's a little bit different.
All of Meister finishes him off. And yeah, that was just a solid round for Fnatic. And this is what they normally do. This is what we normally see them do as well. They rarely mess up versus Ecos. And I think a lot of that comes down to, I guess you could call it conservative playstyle, that Pronax, that philosophy that Pronax has and it brings to his teams, that you're not supposed to lose rounds that you're not supposed to lose. So they play everything safely.
I mean, right now there's a bit of an aggressive push actually coming up to Banana. They're really aggressively peeking this corner, looking to get a kill. Smith will get one, Smith will get both, in fact, and that's Fnatic getting stopped cold. But that is something to touch on that point. That is definitely something that we saw Pronax bring to the team when he first came to the team and started shaking things up. You know, we saw Fnatic going from a team that would lose those kinds of rounds to almost overnight, Pronax just reining them in, and you could really see that drop in tempo. Yeah. Pronax is not one to let a team, you know, give up advantages like that.
No, that is definitely important, though. I'm wondering, I don't know about the peek they just did right over there. That would seem like they threw a lot away, but the screen, they made for a great screenshot. They're both out on the sandbags just resting.
But I'm actually interested to see if Fnatic picks up on the fact, or if they actually saw the game versus now Titan play versus Hellraisers, that Titan do like to play with three people towards B. And they do leave Arch open, and I'm wondering if that's going to persuade Fnatic into going heavily towards A a lot of the time, because normally their playstyle lends itself to having Flusha kind of work by himself towards Banana and create space for the rest of the guys. And I think that would lend itself well for Fnatic.
Olofmeister does pick off one, but they still need the bomb site, and they're not going to get it, so that's the round over. Olofmeister can no longer win this round, and actually he's just going to go down. So Smith's with a triple and Scream with a double, and I guess we all understand what they wanted to do this round, Fnatic, with wrapping around towards the B bomb site, but they just had very little time to try and do it.
And I think it also comes down to Scream and Smith just playing their positions down to a T. Both of them sitting very cautiously back, one behind new boxes, one back in the dark corner, and just not showing themselves. Flusha, he snuck his way through the smoke, looked towards the site, and didn't see anybody. They just did. Fnatic just didn't have any targets to shoot at.
Yeah, and I think we're seeing a pretty more, or what we were, should be able to expect from Fnatic. Like this type of setup coming up from Fnatic right now, with Flusha being the sole guy and Banana JW just keeping tabs on mid. And the rest of the Fnatic members spread around in apps. I think this is what we're going to see as a normal setup from the Swedish team.
Yeah, JW for the first time in the game picking up an AWP, and he instantly got dinked in the middle down to 10 HP. So that's unfortunate, because, you know, you get that pick off in the middle, especially with an AWP like that, just a clean pick off, you're in for a pretty nice start. We'll see if this is all going to change. Flusher, you're right. He is the one up here. And actually, he's being joined now. So I think this looks like they're turning it from being Flusher there to now being Olofmeister alone over here at the A-bomb side. And then a bit of an NIP play. Flash goes out and Smith with a fantastic double pickoff. And Scream with one more. And Pronax is going to try and challenge. And Kenny chimes in. This is actually a pretty tight defense from Titan right now.
Machine. Olofmeister catches MBK rotating through mid, trying to get information. So a good punish there. He's got quite a bit of money, though, Olofmeister. Oh, and he bungles his flash. That's unfortunate. He's not going to be too pleased about that. But Olofmeister, I take it back about what he had the money. He actually needs to hold back. He needs to hold on to this gun at all costs. It'd be a miracle for him to live through this round, though. Titan, they should just let him live, basically, and then kill him after the time goes off.
That'd be the best case scenario.
Yeah. There it is.
All right. Well, the time didn't run out, so that's good, because obviously, in case anyone doesn't know, if you die after the time runs out on the terrorist side only, you don't get any money for losing the round, and you lose your rifle anyway, so things are really bad if you do that. But this is, what, is it a couple of rounds now, I think, for, yeah, so two rounds now for Fnatic without any bomb plant.
Yeah. Two rounds without any bomb plants and two rounds towards B. That hasn't worked out for them. So I'm kind of hoping to see them attack more towards the A bomb site. It just feels like that would be the optimal choice. Yeah.
Did you catch that smoke from NBK?
Yeah, I did.
Oh, Nathan, that was definitely not how it was gonna was supposed to go. But it's all right,
a similar nade.
It was a little bit of a similar.
I was a bit proud of him there.
Kenny's got to be careful. He will fall back, and they're going to run to the most heavily defended spot on the map, which is this pit area. It's so difficult. They're shooting at each other in the meantime as well, so a lot of confusion coming out here from Titan, but they have got the kill on an MBK, and that might be all they get. Flusher, actually, with a good hit pickoff here, still has 6 bullets left and wants to get one more click, but he's going to be able to put the bomb down at least, and that's a huge win in itself.
Well, scary situation, but yeah, he is actually going to manage to get this plant. They know exactly where he was as well. Smith's already pre-firing that angle, even managing to save that off for Kenny S., who did manage to get a kill this round, but we're still waiting to see like the big rounds coming out from Kenny S with that AWP. Both him and JW a little bit lackluster with the sniper rifle so far on this map when they picked it up.
I agree.
So let's see where they decide to take this now. Titan with 5 rounds and starting to get a little bit of bank actually building up on their side. Existence with 7k, 2 members at 5k. So now they're actually starting to have a little bit of breathing room here as far as what happens in these rounds. If they lose a couple of members, they don't have to worry about being under any kind of pressure to re-equip their team and make sure everybody's got the money. Kenny S insta-gibbed in apartments by Olaf Meister, though. Great play there by Olaf. It all came down to the timing, and he completely caught Kenny S off guard.
Yeah, but then he goes down, and so does another person. MBK very nearly got a double kill then. JW down to not that much health. Smith's in the corner, missing some shots, and there's no room for doing that kind of stuff. Now he's going to need help from Scream, who's already just charging in, and Existence will pick up another kill. Has to reload this rifle. JW's already down in the pit with him, and he will get the kill. Now, can Scream do it this time? Last time, he actually had won the 1-on-2, and then he decided to sort of give it away in a little bit of a panic. This time, it's probably going to be even more difficult.
All right, let's see. Scream rushes forward. There's the pop flash. He tries to put a shot through the box. You can do that now after the recent update. Gets one. And now it's all down to the other. But Scream, he doesn't do it. Flusha, once again, 2-0 in the one-on-one clutch situations. Flusha comes out on head again. And that is going to be the end. Fnatic, 4 rounds on the board.
I mean, at that point, you gotta realize that if he hits one less bullet on that pole right there and just hits the player instead... That's the victory, man. That was so close, but nicely done, Flusher. And that's what he's really good at on this team, by the way, as well, are these those clutch situations.
And I'm actually surprised to see MBK picks up the Mag 7 for the second round in a row. And as Semler pointed out the last round, Titan had plenty of money to actually drop for MBK, but he opted for the Mag 7. I think that's a bit of a mistake, even though the Mag 7 is a really strong weapon close up. If you get caught in kind of a semi-long range duel, it's not that effective anymore.
Kenny way over peeking over an archway. Definitely a big mistake. Now let's see how this Mag 7 is going to play out. He's got it in a good position. If they come through quad right now, it's going to be perfect. But you are right. If they go somewhere else, it's not going to be great. And he spots one person up there. So some more information goes the way of Titan. 50 seconds still. And Fnatic could go back to B if they wanted to.
They do, exactly. They have the time, but they've wrapped out of apartments and now they're going up to quad. Scream has used all of his nades over here, playing off of Arch. So this is, they've burned all of the smokes. There's only one left, and that's not Existence. Currently Existence. He's looking towards Arch as well, but now there's 3 members here for Fnatic. As soon as someone peeks, it's going to be an instant punish, and there you have it. But somehow Scream lives through the hail of bullets and even gets a kill.
Oh, you got to be joking. Scream's about to get wrapped around. Crims comes in, and they have to get the shots right now. It's all on him. 20 seconds left, and without the bomb and Titan, I mean, they somehow made the right call going towards Archway and leaving NBK over at those apartments. Crims goes down, and NBK will throw away the Mag 7 and pick up an AK, and he actually got a double kill. So 6-4 here, and another round. I mean, it seems like when Fnatic win the rounds, you know, then obviously they get a bomb down and they're right, but rounds that they lose, they actually don't get any bomb plants, and that is a problem. It's $800 every time you don't get those bomb plants. So right now we're up at what, 2,400 that they haven't got, 2,400.
Yeah,
that's
wait,
that's another buy round basically.
Right? It's 4,500, right? I mean, 5 times 8.
But they've gotten some bomb plants.
Yeah, they've gotten. I think they've had three round losses so far where they haven't put the bomb down. I might be counting wrong, but if it is three, it's at least 4,200 that they're missing just from not putting down the bomb.
Yeah, but I think that's credit to Titan, though, because they're shutting Fnatic down before they're able to execute properly. I mean, we saw that around there as they were walking towards Arch and trying to wrap around the corner. They got shut down. Maybe you could argue that Fnatic should have been able to pick up at least Scream in Library, but yeah, Titan are doing a good job of shutting them down before they get onto sites.
Oh, Flusher almost got a pick off of Nana. Kenny's going to walk in, does get some help, turns around and gets a next kill. So finally, actually, we see Kenny connecting with some shots, and he's been having a weird game so far. I mean, he's had 8 kills, so he's not doing horribly, but he's been missing some shots that he should have missed. And this time, I think it's the first time we've seen him sort of come alive. So now there it is, 7-4, and we're into the 12th round, and Fnatic using all their money here to buy. I mean, if they lose this round, they are... Yeah, they're going to have to eco again, I think. Or just buy Galil's.
I'm just kind of laughing about how strong we are with numbers, man. We're so good. Alright. So, let's see exactly where they decide to take this now. Because Fnatic, they actually do have a reasonable buy going into this. But it does seem, once again, they're just trying to play patient. And see if Titan are going to be able to give them any opportunities to get a freebie here. But Titan, once again, playing a very passive sort of style, not really peeking at mid, not really giving Fnatic any opportunities at the entry frag.
Yeah, and this time around, they haven't put Flusha in Banana at all, and that's giving room for the two members from Titan on B, because they're already pushing down Banana, and this could end horribly for Fnatic if they are not fast to take over that A bomb site.
And I love this setup here. Kenny on the corner, and then Existence very close by if anything happens. Grenade's going to rain out as well, do some damage to JW, and now Kenny falls back. This is looking like a strong defense. Existence going to pick off another kill, and as you said, Vendetta now they're wrapping up behind Smiths. He is just a harbinger of doom, going to be coming up behind them. Crims goes down as well, and it is a flawless round, literally, from Titan. Nobody takes a single point of damage there. 100% HP on everybody.
Yeah, really well defended. And again, Fnatic does not get the bomb down. Actually, they're not even close to the bomb site before they go down. So, yeah. Definitely like what Titan are doing now compared to a few of the rounds we saw versus Hellraisers on their CT side.
Definitely, but it does seem like Titan... Like, I'm still waiting to see their T side, right? Because they still had a solid CT half versus Hellraisers as well, despite a couple, you know... mishaps here and there, yeah. Mishaps, right? They still did manage to actually look pretty solid. It was their T side that makes you wonder. So now we have to see. Olaf Meister, he wants to give them a helping hand again as well, shooting his teammate in the back a little bit with that CZ.
Yeah, and Fnatic are doing the Fnatic tactic here, or they attempted to do it, which is planting inside the smoke there on the A bomb site.
They were creeping up, but MBK and Existence holding it down, and now it's just Flusher left, who's been pretty good with the pistol. It seems every time he points at somebody, it's almost certainly going to be a headshot, except for, you know, just when I said it. And Existence going to finish him off here. A quad kill for the Belgian in-game leader. Puts him on top of the scoreboard on his own team, and actually in the game in general, just sharing that top spot with NBK. We're looking at a 9-4 lead right now for Titan and Fnatic. I mean, this is not over yet. All they need to pick up is, I think, one more round. If this finishes 10-5, Fnatic are definitely still in the game.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Yeah.
And you have to also take into consideration the fact that Titan did win the pistol in this game, which they did not do versus Hellraisers. And versus Hellraisers, they did finish the first half 9-6.
True.
So I don't think Fnatic are out of it at all, but I think they need to get off to a good start on their CT side regardless.
I think a lot of it's going to come down to the pistol yet again, right? But it's good to see NBK and Existence both actually sitting at the top of the scoreboard here for Titan. Existence in particular, same thing for the Hellraisers match, definitely getting those frags for his team. But right now it's going to be all five members curling around on the A site. They're looking for it, but Kenny S is going to get one shot, tries another one, but JW does not give him the opportunity. Now it's going to be closed out on this A site. Existence picked Smith as well.
Yeah, and Crims should have gone down already. A big misplay coming up on Smith here. He will eventually drop, but the bomb is at least going to go down this round for Fnatic. It is a 3-on-2 retake scenario, and Olaf Meister and JW, they have to try and win this. MBK with a little bit of jumping action, and JW trying to hold patiently in here, but he's got to be careful. Wrapping around Olaf Meister, very cool movement here. He could have got a great double kill, but it's still working out just fine for Fnatic at the moment. One goes down, and now it's on Olaf. He has 100% HP. He's going to get the one headshot. Now Kenny running in. And he's going to go for the straight defuse, but Olaf Meister sees it coming. Kenny's waiting right there. He goes out. He's just defusing, and no! Olaf, no! That should have been their round. That was such a great idea from Olofmeister rotating towards Archway. Oh, that's painful.
Well, what I guess... hear right now in the chat, is in like the Titan chat, is just KDS being like, yeah, that's how it's done, right, Scream? You hold down. Pro players don't fake.
But I guess that kind of evens out with the round Scream had, because it seems like there was a bit of miscommunication on Fnatic's part there, because Olofmeister was shooting for the wrong spot, because the bomb was not planted directly behind the spammable blocks. So I guess it kind of evens out, but it really, that's a tough fall for Fnatic, because I think they felt like they should have had that round.
They had that round. I mean, that was it, but... And they fought it back in a really good style as well. I mean, they were in a 2-on-3 and they brought it back into a 1-on-1. So they did a very fine job. It's just that it didn't quite work out. Now they're going to try and see if they can rush down Kenny. But he's going to disappear in the smoke. Like, you know, an evil villain with an AWP just trying to see if he can find another shot. And actually hiding right on the side of the smoke is JW. They're sort of bumping into each other and Smith's is going to go down as a result. So maybe this can still work out. It is now a 2-on-2 and they have the health advantage and the bomb down.
JW is so close to Kenius as well. This is the thing. Right side out of library. Scream has to know this information, and he's not going to get it. JW will take Scream out. Now it's all down to Kenny. Point blank on JW. Picks him off. And it's down to Pronax sitting in the pit. Trying not to show himself. Gets the jump on Kenny. Actually does some damage as well through the truck. But Kenny, he's like, no, I don't want to actually take this fight. I'm going to smoke you off, get rid of you, and try and get onto this site to see if I can get the defuse.
A great flashbang coming out from Pronax, though, and he's walking around smart. Look how smart Pronax is. This is absolutely genius. Kenny has no chance of knowing, and he's going to go down. So 10-5 for the first half, and a very, very important round at the end here for Fnatic. That, I think, puts them right back in the game. If they just win the pistol round of the second half here, then we have a very close game on our hands.
Yeah, absolutely. I think that's completely correct. And it's going to be exciting to see whether or not Titan are able to pick up the second pistol this time around, simply because they lost both pistols versus Hellraisers. Now they started off winning it versus Fnatic, so maybe they can keep up the good trend. That would definitely be a big deal for them if they can get to 13 rounds before Fnatic are able to buy up.
Well, just think if Titan had actually picked up that first round pistol versus Hellraisers, we would have had pretty much the identical score.
Yeah.
You know, that one round could be what makes the difference here for Titan. Just getting that one pistol round in, getting a little bit of that buffer. this could be the difference maker or the deal breaker.
Look, if you are just joining us, then welcome to the channel. It's at Room on Fire you're on right now, and welcome to the show, and thanks for joining us. This is the SLTV Star Series Season 10 between Titan and Fnatic, and thank you all of you guys spamming that Room on Fire logo that we just added to the chat. Really appreciate that, guys. Thanks for subscribing as well. It helps us out a lot. We're basically running this on our own, so we really need all the help we can get. And also, if you just want to support us a little bit, you can just always click the follow button on the stream, and that also helps us out in the long run. But here we go, second half coming up, and Pronax single-handedly defending this B bomb site with a USPS, running out of bullets as well, but a good shot comes in. He has to reload. He's going for one more, and now they're going to be flooding this bomb site, and this is not going to be easy for Pronax. They're up close. They should just commit to this Titan. They take a little bit of time, and Flusher will pick off one, and then two, and I don't know what happened to this round. I think Titan had a great chance to do this.
This is what happened. Okay, well, now we can watch here. His existence is going to get caught in the sandwich. No, not a hope, not a prayer. And they do manage to get one kill, but this was the same versus Hellraisers, wasn't it? They couldn't catch it. They couldn't catch the man before he got around the corner, and this time it was Pronax. And instead of stopping and just resetting, slowing the pace down, and just trying to gather themselves and come up with a new plan, they just decided to go for it, full YOLO.
That's the thing, that's what I don't get, is they didn't actually go full YOLO on it. They kind of did, but MBK just... I mean, they
that
did...
That was full YOLO.
No, just MBK pushed up. That's the thing. If they had gone full YOLO, at least they could have got the bomb down and killed Pronax. But MBK was the only one pushing up. That's what I don't get. It's like they... Half the team went YOLO, and half the team was like, let's wait it up.
I think maybe we're confusing what full YOLO means here. What I mean by full YOLO is they decided to go for the B site anyway. And Flusher was able to still get those two kills because... them delaying it that long allowed for Flusher to get in position at CT spawn. Get that freebie of the man who ran in through yellow, didn't catch the first frag, but then to get the second one through the smoke like that on Kenny S, I mean, that's just shattering for Titan. That slows them down completely.
Man, we'll see. That was, I mean, it's always easier for us to make those kind of calls, but it did look like they were...
Sure.
They were a little bit confused about what was going on then, and maybe they didn't have a plan once they lost the guy early on. This time they have gone for armor on three people, and then obviously CC at 75s and Deagle and everything else that they can try and pick up here.
They're taking some damage here to begin with. Titan, no luck really for them this time around. NBK missed an opportunity. Scream, he's got the deagle, which I love to see. He needs to go for it, but Fnatic play it down to a T. Two members whip around the corner and take his head off.
Yeah, Krim's doing a fine job over here, getting smiced over the flashbang, and it's an easy round for Fnatic. In my mind, though, I saw Scream with like a, you know, double deagle headshot, just like one click. But
yeah, when both of them were running out from the arch corner, I saw it too.
Just
hoping, I think we all
right?
saw that. And in our mind's eye, you know, we're all just picturing it happening and then, you know, falling out of our chairs.
Yeah.
But then reality kicked in, and reality isn't as fun.
Yeah, flush out the killer of dreams.
Not always. Okay, well, we'll see. JW's actually stolen that deagle and is now just aiming down the middle. It feels like Titan are taking it slowly up the second mid, and obviously it is another eco round coming up. And then they have bought two smokes, which could be an indication that they want to try and see if they can at least get the bomb down here.
Well, they need to, really, at this point. But Existence...
I think this is an MM strat.
Ah, well, they're starting to fall back now.
Okay, so they were just feeling things out over at the A-bomb side. I guess Existence might have hoped for a bigger commitment from Fnatic down Banana. But it was not to be.
That seemed like the full QK strat. But, like, you know, not instead of putting two guys in apartments, you put four guys in apartments, and then you hope that they just kind of rotate off of B and let you walk up there with a bomb.
Still making some noise over at the A-bomb side this time, though, but... they are leaving Krims very much alone. I mean, Olofmeister's kind of close by, but if they straight rush Krims down, this round can actually work out all right for Titan. Winning it is still going to be difficult. Ow! NBK with a good headshot there. Flush it down very low. Now it's on Krims, and last time he did just fine in this position, and Olofmeister's already here, so look how well they're planning this, Fnatic. Oh! Okay.
The caster curse strikes again. Well, now Olofmeister has to actually be very patient here. They will get a bomb plant. This takes a lot of damage, but he picks up a FAMAS in the exchange, and he's going to be able to rush down. Olofmeister just barely gets the kill.
And look
at
Flusher.
That was a close call.
Flusher so low. JW, or sorry, is low. Pronax has 100% HP, but this is not good, Fnatic. Maybe a little bit too aggressive now. Pronax, he's got to be the man here. 1-on-3. He takes down one, and bomb is still ticking away. He's got the kit, but no grenades. He can't really do anything. He's going to defuse once, just faking it out. He's not holding it down. And Titan, they have read this situation so well, and it's too late. Pronax going to run out. What a turnaround. I mean, Kenny, what a time to get a shot like that.
Yeah, I was about to commend Krims and having a pretty safe position over at the B bomb side, because as you mentioned, he was somewhat alone. Even though Olofmeister was nearby, he wouldn't be able to really help out Krims in the case of the B rush.
But
and
what?
He just got insta-dinked. That was just a great shot from the
Titan
player.
What's so cool about the way they were holding it is that the way Olof throws that flashbang into yellow, it doesn't actually flash Krims at all because he's being sort of guarded by the coils themselves.
Yeah.
So it's a really good idea, just didn't work out. And this time, JW investing in an AWP goes down, Krims trapped in a corner, and they should be able to grenade him down, but they keep peeking him, taking him down. Olofmeister with a FAMAS goes down, and Titan are off to a fantastic start in the second half, in spite of Fnatic winning the pistol round.
Yeah, they are pretty low on HP, though, on Scream and Kenny S, so this is definitely doable for Flesha and Pronax, but they can't use too much time, and I think that's going to be the big issue for the Swedes.
I think that's what's costing them at this point. Like, look at the positioning right now. Flesha with already a good clean kill on Scream. Kenny S, however, is very low, but definitely keeping away from the action at this point. It's going to be Smiths, who is just waiting patiently around the corner, baits Pronax in with his teammate, and gets the job done.
Flusher takes the kill even while jumping in a little bit of a weird way, but they also had a Molotov to keep Flusher out here over by Flowers, so a lot working for Titan at the moment, and worse still. I mean, this is the Frenchmen starting to build up their own economy, but Fnatic after Ego, it's 12-7 at the moment, and Titan are looking, they're looking primed to win this game.
Yeah, that's what's on the table here. This is big. Fnatic can't afford to spend too much money because they can't really allow Titan to get past this point. They're about to give him 13 rounds, but that's it. They have to draw the line in the sand and not let Titan get past this.
Olofmeister goes down. Last time it was JW dying in that exact spot, so maybe it's time to give up trying to hide behind the car there. Smith very nearly gets caught off, but he gets out of there in time. And, you know, again, the B-bomb site is a little bit weaker here for Fnatic.
Okay, NBK. Lady Luck smiled and he got a headshot, and now it's going to be Flesha and Pronax. Both members alive, and in a 2-on-5, and Titan, they're so insanely patient. Pronax will get punished with a good double headshot from Pronax. Nicely done there with the USPS. But at this point, it will be cleaned up. Smith and Scream with the final two frags. Titan, they continue on to 13 rounds. But now, is it going to be enough here for Fnatic to get a reasonable buy-in? And yes, it will. They actually have quite a bit. Surprising amount, actually. I thought that they would be a little bit more strapped for cash.
Yeah, no, they do have enough to buy, but and actually, yeah, it's four smokes as well, so they're gonna be all right on the you know, just trying to delay Titan. But I'm really scared right now if Titan win this upcoming round. I mean, we all know what happens. It's basically Fnatic, you know, planning for a flawless second half from here on out. JW peaks a little bit. He needs some backup quickly here. Does take a lot of damage, but not enough to bring him down. And Titan just falls back after having, you know, softened him up a little bit.
It's been a fair trade, actually. NBK eating a little bit of nade damage at the bottom of Banana as well. You know, thanks to Crims, basically. You know, Crims, generous guy, gives him a bit of shrapnel. But this is such an important round for Fnatic, essentially. This is pretty much the map right here for Fnatic. So this is a high-pressure situation for the Swedes. And Smith catches Pronax out. Great kill there to open things up on the A site.
Yeah, JW now trying to take over where Pronax left off. And Scream is actually just going to smoke this off. And right on his position, what a great smoke. Basically designed to just move JW out of there, but they're gonna work back towards the B bombsite. Crims is gonna peek out and spots two people. What a great spray! NBK and Kenny are gone, and now, well, Existence, if he mans up and goes through here, they might just lose the bomb, and they're still in a 3-on-4, so I'm kind of glad he's not doing that. Over at Archway, though, Smith comes in, takes down Flusher, JW caught in the middle, and Smith with a great triple kill in spite of all that Crims has done. It might not be enough here.
No, but this is still feasible, but it's going to be insanely difficult. There's no kit on Fnatic right now, so they don't have much time. This bomb needs to be planted yesterday. Existence needs to put it down right now. 10 seconds left, and they finally get the plant, and Fnatic are already on this site. So now it comes down to Titan just trying to hold the spots that they've stuck in. Two guys in pit and one on the site, and Existence even has a poly. This is beyond perfect.
Yeah, it really is. Crim's low on health. It's going to peek out. He misses the first shot, and I think that's the only chance he's going to actually get to get a pick health here. He's going to go down. Smith, even with the Glock and all of Meister, is just manning up against everybody, and that is not the way to play. Smith to the end with a quad kill and a sick round from him. He's also, by the way, top fragging at 21, 2 assists and 10 deaths. By far the best ratio in the game at the moment, so well played, Smith. I mean, normally, we sort of, I don't want to say we count him out, but we pay more attention to Smiths when we're on Dust 2. Not so much on Inferno, maybe. So, yeah, well played.
True. Yeah, he's been stepping up a lot. And same with Existence as well. Actually, everyone from Titan is playing really well right now. And I think that's kind of a bit of a difference, because we're seeing a lot less errors coming out from the French team now than what we did versus Hellraisers. And we can already see the results. They're up 7 rounds.
It's probably that the Hellraisers match was a bit of the warm-up, right? Like, okay, they got the juices flowing, and now they're up against Fnatic. Fnatic are taking the brunt of the damage here, because Fnatic have to go for a mix by double shoddy and a rifle, a couple pistols, but that's all they have to work with here and in this round to keep Titan from getting match point.
And they almost had the timing as well. This round, Crims actually threw out a pop flash, and all of Titan were right outside by this card where Olaf Meister is now, but they fell back just before the flash reined in, and then he just had no one to kill. That could have been some really great timing for Fnatic. I mean, you got to give the Swedes credit. They are trying to do whatever they can to get back into this game, but it is not looking easy. This time, up in the apartments, Pronax is about to get backstabbed. He's, oh, actually turns around and gets the kill. That's some swift movement. Flusher with one as well. He's going to go for one more. 5-7 in hand. He does go down, and that leaves just one guy in the bombsite, but backup is here really quickly. 3-on-3.
But they're already here, Fnatic. They did not buy the fake. They've rotated everybody over to the A side as quickly as possible. And now it's all going to be NBK taking point. JW gets one with the swag. NBK gets caught in the crossfire. And now it's all down to Kenny S with an AWP and a 1v3 with 15 seconds left. There's the first kill on Pronax. But it's still two left on this site for him to find with 10 seconds left. He gets all of Meister. But JW, peekaboo, gets the kill. And that's it. The end of Fnatic. Keep their hopes alive.
I think Olaf Meister was equally surprised as us from that shot. That made no sense whatsoever, because there's no way Kenny S saw Olaf Meister sneaking in behind there.
No. That was just a guess. He's like, where, oh, where would Olaf Meister be?
Might
now,
be here.
That's the problem with that box now. You can't actually hide behind it. You take way too much damage.
Yeah, it's actually crazy how much damage. It's basically like there's no resistance. Yeah, definitely a risky move.
But box made of cotton.
I like that change. I like that change. Pretty good.
So that puts us at 14-8 now. I mean, a six-round difference doesn't sound like that much, but Fnatic, no. I mean, even now more than ever, they need to just win, because if they lose this round, they will have no money for the final round. They'll just outright lose, so they have their backs against the wall quite a lot here.
Yeah, and even after winning a round, they still have to force up with FAMASes and whatnot. Luckily for them, though, even though Kenyas does have an AWP, NBK's only kitted out with a Deagle.
No, JW had the angle, but Kenny's so quick right now. He's really stepped it up in the last couple of rounds. And now Pronax and Flusher are defending. Flusher picks up an AWP, and that was not the right time to do that. Pronax trying to see if he can save his team. I mean, he is the captain, and he's going to really have to lead if they're going to win this. Sick shot from Olofmeister takes down Kenny, and actually brings it back into a 3-on-2 now in favor of Fnatic. They are not giving up the Swedes here.
Yeah, if Kenny has missed an opportunity, he decided to stick around and he got punished for it. You can't take that risk versus Olofmeister. He will mess you up. But now it's going to be Fnatic just gathering up, and they're looking to split this side up. Two guys to short, one to Arch, and they're going to wrap around. It's all going to come down to whether Smith can actually hold them off from the pit. He's in a good position to catch them before they can get.
Yeah, there's the one kill.
His teammate drawing this out, and there you have it.
Sick triple from Smith, and he's not even taking any damage. There it is. He's down to 2 HP, and Crims is running out of time to do this. He's going to have to go for the straight defuse here. 3 seconds, 2 seconds. Smith's not going to peek. 1 second left. He does get the kill, but he doesn't win the round. Crims, nerves of steel right there, just keeps doing it. Man, that was so close. Oh, if he had peeked 1 second earlier, he would have.
There's been so many rounds like this in this game already. I think that's the third time it comes down to someone just straight defusing like a man.
Really, man. And that's the thing. I think Fnatic are just... It was Kenny S and then Fnatic. I don't know. Fake defusing is not the way. Clearly.
Because Pronax and Scream,
they haven't had... Yeah, exactly. Pronax and Scream didn't work. When they held down, though.
Magic happens when you hold down the E button.
Just got to commit to it. Although it is a lot more frightening when you're actually doing it than when you're just talking about it.
That's very true.
Okay, moving into the 24th round, and we are still at a pretty good lead for Titan. And unfortunately for Fnatic, even winning that round, they lost every single member of the team. So they just don't have that much money, and they're still just on the very edge of losing this game, basically. JW close here with a mag 7, and you know he's just picking off where MBK left off. I think JW's been the more popular using this than maybe MBK has.
Definitely. Train.
Nuke. Yeah.
Yeah, that's JW with the swag.
Everywhere. Everywhere.
Yeah. But he's been making it work as well. I mean, the Bank of Fnatic. There's a reason he has that nickname.
Oh, Flusher walking in. Smith goes down. Great job. And also Flusher doing a lot of damage to existence here. So this is working out really well. Fnatic, maybe it is time for the comeback. If they can win this game, that would certainly be something. It is a 3-on-5, and although Existence has a good position to do some backstabbing, it's too late. The rest of his team is basically already dead. Scream, the only one alive over here, and it's just a question of time now. So this is good news for Fnatic.
I've had flashbacks to Hellraisers, you know.
Flusher just smells that something's cooking in the library. I don't know how he knew, but somehow he figured out that that's where Existence was holding.
The one thing that I wonder is, was he able to count the steps towards Arch, right? Did he?
That might have been it, because it definitely heard someone running in towards CT spawn.
Oh, that's how he caught. Sure, that's how he caught Smiths.
Yeah, yeah, and but then he caught Kenny S right after, so he might have. I guess he might have thought that the steps he was hearing was Kenny S running back and forth between the speedway.
Ow.
But in any case, it worked out, and finally, Fnatic actually survives with a couple of people. Actually, they survived all five that round, and that's definitely what they need. Because even if they lose this round, which obviously is a big loss for them, they're still going to be able to buy up.
Oh, Smith's almost opened up that bombsite. He almost killed both people, and he's the only one who has an AK, but the rest of his team can't pick up on all that damage. So they're actually just going to get smoked off. I mean, I'm really questioning why they did this. Smith's, he wasn't just equalizing his money. He's down to $500, so this is a bit of an issue. But Titan keeps soldiering on. They're going to try and push through, but Crims is just going to shut them down here. Kenny goes down, and Existence the last one. So, I mean, to be fair, Smith's could have killed both Olofmeister and Crims there, and that would have probably won Titan the round. But when it doesn't happen, now they're just in a really awkward situation where, I mean, Smith's, he's going to have to buy, what, CSET 75 and armor instead of a rifle.
Yeah, but Titan's done this quite a bit, actually, so far. Well, already in this game, and they did the same thing versus Hellraisers. They're perfectly content with having one guy left out to dry, pretty much, when it comes to their buy rounds. We saw MBK having to go with the Deagle a couple of rounds ago and that kind of stuff. And they're happy to do it. Same thing with the Existence. He'll gladly, not take a drop to let his teammates get maybe a Colt instead of a FAMAS.
Well, you have some teams that are willing to do that, right? Yeah. Hellraisers, Doja takes the hit when they're not afraid to have Doja take the hit. Dignitas, Fetish. So, yeah. I mean, there are some players like that who are just like, okay, well, it's fine. I'll go with the pistol. Smith has been picked off, so he doesn't even really manage to pick up a gun anywhere. And right now, it's just everything going Fnatic's way. Two kills to start.
And some incredibly strange decision-making coming out from Titan here. I mean, NBK over on Banana, that seemed completely insane, almost suicidal, just walking into the smoke and firing away because they can just easily return that fire. And then up in the apartments, I guess Smith, he just had a pistol. He just wanted to see what was going on, and he sort of lost his life doing that. But this is not the time for Titan to start, wobbling. They got to keep their heads in this game. Otherwise, Fnatic will come back and win this.
That's what I'm worried about as well. Titan, they definitely seem to get a little shaky when things aren't going their way. We saw it in the Hellraisers match where they just started to lose momentum as soon as Hellraiser started putting rounds together. Titan just seemed to have to struggle harder and harder to get anything going. Good headshot there by Existence, though, to open things up on the A site, picking off Flusha.
Yeah, but it's not enough. JW had a really great position. He's going to take a quick double kill. Turns around. Actually, will go down, but it doesn't matter. Really smart position from JW, looking over that smoke and knowing that when they come through there, they were probably going to be more focused on the pit. Titan can buy now, but that's mostly a result of them losing the last five rounds in a row. So their consecutive round loss bonus has been building up, and now from a six-round difference right into a two-round difference. This is where the game gets really scary for both teams, actually. I mean,
yeah, you don't want to make mistakes at this point. That's pretty much what it comes down to. And now we see Fnatic do something that we haven't seen in a while, and that's instead of just stacking up with three people towards Banana just to hold B, they're actually taking control over Banana, and I like this move.
Yeah, they did take some damage doing it. I think there were some counter grenades thrown out, but the control here is definitely going to matter a lot. And Olofmeister puts up a smoke. There's still one on Crims, so they can hold on to this place for a long time, and Titan is just going to try and rotate out. And if Titan go for A now, when there's still two people on Banana, it's a lot better than if they wait.
Ooh, that nade.
Yeah.
That nade.
That was the money ball from Pronex right there. They just need to hold, because they're softened off.
The magic apple. Oh, he's going to peek out right in front of them, and he does take down two people. Nice timing and nice teamwork from Fnatic. Inside the bomb site, Flusha is waiting. He's going to pick up one more. That's the bomb down again, and Smith is going to go down. And Fnatic, in spite of all the damage they took early on, they just make it work. I mean, the grenade from Pronax was beautiful, but that flashbang coming in from a teammate and then him peeking behind it worked out great. And Titan, they could go for a buy. It'd be two Galils and three AKs, and they are going to go for it.
Are they really?
What?
No, it's going to be Smith's once again, just picking up a Galil. Not even an AK, a Galil.
And no armor, either.
Yeah.
So it's the weirdest committal to a round, or to a buy I've seen in a long time.
And then Scream picks up two flashes and a smoke and gets Kevlar helmet. Is he just expecting Smith to die and then he's going to pick up the gun?
Maybe, but I guess Smith is going to have enough money to buy out fully next round, because have lost so many rounds in a row. So I guess that's why. But that also means that more of the Titan players could have done the same. So I'm just surprised that there's not really any consistency among the players.
Yeah, I have no words for what we just... That's just very confusing. Obviously, Existence is going to be alone. It will be 14-14. The game is going to draw here.
Yeah, did you catch Pronax with that pop flash right there when he took out Kenny S?
No.
Ah, very cool. Very, very cool pop flash using the geometry of the apartments. He banked it off three walls, basically, so that it lands at his feet as he takes a peek around that corner. And I'm wondering if that's the one he used to bop them up in the last round as well.
No, that was a teammate throwing it in.
That was a teammate? Okay, so this one was just basically Pronax solo. Banks it off the three walls. It lands at his feet. Kenny Guess is completely blind, going for the bait, which was the Galil. And Pronax gets it. Just a small detail there. Would have been cool to see.
We're at 14-14, and this is Fnatic's chance to actually come back and win the game if they're in the next two rounds in a row, but the same is true for Titan. It is really close right now, and it's a little bit scary. It must be for both Team Titan. Oh, they're taking so much damage in the middle, but they get the kill in return. Olofmeister all the way over on Banana actually goes down, and I think that was a boost that they had done on top of MBK here. So a nice start for Titan. Now, can they actually hold it together? That's the question.
That's what you have to wonder. Existence with that kill, very nicely done by him. Threw a pretty good nade as well that I thought was going to do a whole lot more damage on the guys in Banana, but luckily for Fnatic, they get away with a minimal amount. But the important thing here is that Titan actually have that man advantage, right? They are going to be able to just try and play off of this, force the rotations out of Fnatic, and take advantage of that.
You gotta imagine that Existence Mind right now is just working overtime, trying to figure out exactly what the best idea is. Pronax, I mean, we can see that Pronax is alone over here, but if he calls for backup, he still has a smoke. He can definitely do this now. They're going to fall back, leaving one guy that Smith's walking in through Archway. If he takes down Crims, it's definitely game on, but he gets caught with the grenade out, and Crims sees him coming. That's actually just going to, that's going to leave Flusher coming in here, and now Pronax waiting right at the edge. He's going to push through right in the face of Titan, and they're walking into each other. No one's shooting Pronax! Fire your rifle! He's just letting them walk past. He's going to walk up right behind them, and with the M4A1, he gets the kill, picks up the AK, and now the rest of Fnatic are here. This might be where Titan just fall down as a team. Bomb goes down, but that might not be enough here. Pronax cleaning up, a triple for him. Kenny all on him, and he is just going to be rushed down here. 15-14 for Fnatic. Oh my god, what patience on Pronax.
The balls on that guy.
Yeah, that was Doja level right there.
Yeah, and the fact that he doesn't panic when I think it was like three Titan members like getting stuck in Pronax as well. That was just
how
crazy.
Do they not realize? I guess they just assumed that they're bumping into the guy in front of them.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I think that was, we're bumping into each other. Exactly. Yeah, that was crazy.
That was unreal.
That move alone just wins Fnatic the round. Even if Pronax doesn't get more than just that one frag, it causes so much havoc within the ranks of Titan because they all of a sudden have no control over the situation anymore.
And they've purchased 3 AWPs on Titan. On the T side of Inferno, that has got to be a first. And they actually get a shot through on Olaf Meister as well. Smiths picks off Pronax, the triple orb strat. Are we about to revolutionize Counter-Strike here?
Please make
it happen. It's definitely an interesting idea here, but I can't really see it working. How are they going to be able to take a site?
I have no, I mean,
I don't even know.
I think it's up to Fnatic to actually peek too aggressively.
That's the thing. Are Fnatic even going to peek at this point? When they're a man down. They have to peek to get the info, sure, but this is really risky business here. Flusher with a good smoke onto short. That's gonna funnel or at least slow Titan down. Lets him get into a better position in pit. And Fnatic can actually rotate it another two guys over to this A side. There's three members for the defense here, and now the sweeps, they have to hold.
Oh god, we could be looking at a game draw here. There is no overtime in this league, and right now we're at a 5-on-3. It's on Flusher right now. He's gonna have to do so well. He takes down one, has to do more. There's a quick double JW with a kill. Are you joking? Titan, are they really gonna lose that 5-on-3? It seems like they will. Fnatic make the comeback 16-14. Oh god, what a sick game.
I think that last round showed why you don't go triple op on T-side of Inferno. Because, yeah, they...